evening. I don't know how long it's been since we've had a children's Christmas program here at Elizabeth Chapel. Chances are some of the children in that program might be youth in this program tonight. I'm glad you're here. There's a lot of excitement. And I deliberately did not come into any rehearsals so that I could be as excited as any of you and see this for the first time tonight. Let me offer prayer before they begin. God, we give you thanks for the season. We give you thanks for your great love in Jesus Christ. And at this time of Advent and as we head toward Christmas, we thank you for the children and for each adult who has had a part in preparing for this program. And we wait and listen and receive with gratitude what will be presented tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
A long time ago, in the city of Nazareth, there was a woman named Mary. Mary was promised to marry a man named Joseph, who lived there too. One day, an angel from God came and talked to Mary. She told Mary she was going to have a baby.
Mary, you are going to have a baby. He will be the Son of God.
Joseph wasn't sure what to do when he heard that Mary was going to have a baby. So one night, while he was asleep, the angel came and talked to Joseph too.
Joseph, Mary's going to have a baby.
And so that's just what he did. Because Joseph was in the house of the line of David, And Bethlehem was known as the city of David.
The lips of the Lord Jesus. Did you know that your baby boy will one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will take our sons and daughters? Did you know that your
the stars are brightly shining.
place called Jerusalem, there lived an evil king named Herod. One day, after baby Jesus had been born, wise men came to Jerusalem looking for the newly born king of the Jews. They asked King Herod where he was. So the king asked his advisors,
In Bethlehem, go and find
himself
and worship him too.
So the wise men went and found the baby Jesus by following his star, and when they found him, they worshipped him. But King Herod didn't really want to worship baby Jesus. He wanted to harm him. The wise men were warned by God about this, so they went home another way. When the king had found out that he had been tricked, he was really mad. He was determined to destroy this newborn king, so King Herod sent his soldiers to Bethlehem to find the baby Jesus.
Go and find him and destroy him.
But God warned Joseph in his dream to get out of there.
Get out of there.
And so they did. And so Joseph and Mary and the little baby Jesus went to Egypt, and they stayed there until the evil King Herod died. After King Herod died, God told Joseph it was safe to come back because the people who wanted the child dead had now died. Mary and Joseph and baby Jesus came back from Egypt, and they went to live in the town of Nazareth again. And that's where baby Jesus grew up until he was born.
Thank you.
Yes, yes.
There are a lot of people to thank for this room, but I want to recognize one of the loveless girls. If you're a loveless, would you raise your hand? That's fine. This congregation has prayed for a number of years to have more children and to have an active children's program. And I tell you what, my grace, I'll sit down just a minute. I'm not going to get too long-winded, but we have prayed, and we've had an active children's committee, and we do an excellent job of Vacation Bible Schools. And, well, this calendar year, something has happened. And we've been talking about children's church, and our children's leaders have been naming some people and trying to get that organized. And Joyce Maines, another one of those loveless girls, called her sister Peggy and said, "How about coming and helping with this?" And it's no secret, we've gone from sometimes two or three children for a children's church on Sunday mornings to having 12 to 20. And this program is icing on the cake. Peggy, thank you. Okay. There will be a lot of people to thank just for this program, but putting it in the whole perspective, thanks to parents and grandparents and relatives and friends and neighbors, and glory be to God, and thanks be to God. Now, I've got one other little story. I don't want to take any, I'm not stealing any light from this program, but Billy Crow brought a young couple into the church after most everybody had left this morning. And I thought somebody probably needs help, but was I surprised? Friends of friends had heard that we were trying to raise money to feed the children of Emmett School during the Christmas break. Now these two young adults, and they are young, wanted to help. And they didn't, you know, they didn't stop with thinking what they could give. They went to their co-workers, and the wife is in school, a nursing student, and she went to her fellow students. And they had come this morning to present a total of it's over $1,000 to help feed the children. Now, some of us worry sometimes how we're going to afford this and how we're going to do that. And God has a way of responding far, far greater than we ask or think or expect. Jesus did say several things about children, besides being the baby himself, as we celebrate Christmas. Jesus also said that, when you do something for one of these little ones, you've done it for me. And then he also said that unless you become like one of them, In your way of wonder and acceptance and excitement, unless you become like one of them, you won't enter the kingdom of heaven. Thank you, children and leaders, for presenting the Christmas story in such a good way. And thank you all for coming and sharing this. There will be refreshments downstairs. And Give them all a hand one more time.
Let's pray for me. Hold it, Angie. Hold it out and hold it. God, we give you thanks. We give you praise. Your miracles are still being performed as the angels sang at Bethlehem, so you would tell us today and tonight. Do not fear, but accept and receive the news of our Savior and live at peace with one another. Thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.